Police would tie it. A scramble in the Hartford zone, and a helmetless Al Secord with an opportunistic loose puck ties the game at one. Now watch Sylvain Turgeon. He's been rumored in trade talks in Hartford, but ever since the rumors, he's been scoring. He makes it 2-1 Whalers. Later on in the third period, 2-1 Hartford. Turgeon this time feeds Ray Ferraro. And Ferraro is not afraid to crash the net, is he? He scores. Hartford wins it by a score of 3-1. They vault now into third place, tied with Quebec. In the Adams Division, the Maple Leafs have only won once in their last seven. The Washington Capitals have lost a bunch of one-goal games in this season. Tonight, they are taking on the New Jersey Devils, who have one of the best records at home in all the National Hockey League. The Devils were looking for a first-place position in the Patrick Division. Bengt Gustafson for Washington and Dale Hunter on a 2-on-1. They use Mark Johnson as a screen. Gustafson scores shorthanded. It is 2-0 Washington. With a score 2-1 Washington, the Devils shorthanded, and Doug Sullivan gets it over the blue line to Patrick Sundstrom. Beats Vlarchik. We're tied at 2. Second period, 3-2 Devils, but the Caps on the power play. Gustafson gets a stick in the face from Craig Willanen. No matter, he gets it to Dale Hunter, and Hunter scores to tie the game at 3. Now midway through the third period, Mike Gartner and Bengt Gustafson on a 2-on-1 against Bruce Driver. Gustafson with the pass, and he'll make up his mind right at the last split second to beat Kevin Hatcher. So it actually became a 3-on-1, and Hatcher's goal wins it for the Caps as they beat the Devils by a score of 4-3, so the Devils don't go in the first in the Patrick Division. Chicago and Minnesota. This game at Chicago Stadium in a Norris Division battle. Let's take a look at some of the highlights. 2-1 Blackhawks in the first period and a penalty shot for Troy Murray. He cruises in on the goaltender Karitako and he beats him between the pads. Let's take another look at a real rarity in the NHL, the penalty shot. Troy Murray with the wrist shot as Taco went down 3-1 Chicago. But back came the North Stars. Brian Bellows had a great night. You're seeing number 23 Bellows to Dennis Marouk. Bellows with an assist. He also had 3 goals on the night. So Minnesota comes back from a 3-1 deficit, wins at Chicago 6-4. The Red Wings and the Blues at the St. Louis Arena. The Blues came into the game leading the Norris Division by 1 point over Detroit. 1-1 after the first, down the second period. Wings on the power play. Steve Yzerman passing over to Jeff Sharples. Sharples takes his time and rockets the puck past Greg Millen. 2-1 Detroit. 4:10 into the period, Tony McKegney shoots near the blue line and beats Drake Steffen to tie the game at 2. A score there by McKegney of the Blues, who's been hot. Now 56 seconds left in the second period. Gerard Gallant to Doug Hallward, not known as a goal scorer. He still beats Greg Millen, and that's the way the game ended. Detroit wins it by a score of 3-2, so Jacques Demers' club is back on top in the Norris Division by 1 point over St. Louis. Edmonton and Philadelphia, this game has been a blowout from start until present time. All Edmonton. We'll pick it up 1-0 Edmonton. The Oilers are shorthanded. No matter. Gretzky works his magic to Kevin Lowe. Beats Hextall 2-0 Edmonton. Gretzky sparks the Oilers again as Edmonton came out flying in this game. Gretzky to Curry. Jari Curry feeds number 10. Asa Tikkanen. Tikkanen hanging around in the slot. Now Ron Hextall thinks there's an Oiler in the crease. Tikkanen beats Hextall. Hextall's going after the ref. He gets a misconduct. The fact is that there was no Oiler in the crease at the time the shot was taken. Hextall got a 10-minute misconduct for that little outburst of temper. With a score of 3-0 in the second period, Dave Hannon, the former Pittsburgh Penguin, threads a hole through the Philadelphia defense, and he scores on the backhand. That made it 4-0. Right now it is Edmonton 5 and Philadelphia nothing at the Northlands Coliseum. Winnipeg and Los Angeles are a score 3-1. The Kings are on top as we get set for the second period of play. 2 goals by Luke Robitaille in the first.
It's time for Lifestyles of the...